And until we get equal access to accommodation, education, employment, to name but a few, our mental health will remain a crisis. So, as the speakers earlier on said, there seems to be a lack of political will to address the issue of mental health. Meanwhile, our people are dying. We are not to blame. There is not a lack of will from us to try and save our young people and help them feel that life is worth living. There is hope, we're very resilient, but we can't do it on our own. No one can bring about change on their own. We need people to stand in solidarity with us, and we also need that political will. And as Eileen said earlier on, that political will is inside these fancy railings. We need the people in power to put procedures in place to ensure that we have equal aspects in all areas of society. But this should not come at a price. We shouldn't have to sacrifice our identity as Irish travellers to get Irish travellers to be treated equal. So on Taoiseach, me, Al Martin, and other party leaders, we're calling on you today to show that political will. This protest is just the start of our national mental health campaign, and it's gathering momentum by the day. We campaigned for over 30 years to have our ethnic identity recognised by the government. We don't want to campaign for another 30 years to have our mental health recognised, and we don't want to be losing any more of our community in the meantime while we're waiting for our mental health to be recognised. Can I just finish up with acknowledging as well today on International Human Rights Day that even though we're here today to highlight the issue of traveller mental health, we also know that many families, regardless of what community you belong to, mental health issues does not discriminate against anybody. So regardless of what community you belong to or who you are, and are suffering with poor mental health and have lost loved ones, we as travellers stand in solidarity with you also. You are not alone. Reach out and talk to someone. And no matter how bad it seems, no one should feel that life is not worth living. Stay safe and thank you.
So my name is Geraldine MacDonald and I am a member of the National Traveller Mental Health Network, and we're here today to hand in a letter to the leader of our country, Micheál Martin, and we want to call for some action and changes to be made regarding traveller mental health. So we're hearing a lot of talk and we're in a lot of policies and a lot of recommendations, but nothing has happened. So we need something done after this protest today, and we would like to thank everybody who came to the protest and those who couldn't make it on the network as well. We're here representing for them today. There's loads of travellers around the country that would have loved to be here today, but they're representing with the rest of the network, and they're here in solidarity with us anyway.
My name is Thomas McCann. Today we gathered outside of Dáil Éireann the 10th of December to mark International Human Rights Day, and particularly to bring a focus to the situation of travellers in Ireland. Travellers in Ireland has faced institutionalised racism and a denial of human rights for decades at this stage. And what we were doing today was calling on the Taoiseach to take immediate action to address this. We have met with ministers, with junior ministers, with civil servants. We've been on consultative committees. We've been engaged in round tables and reports and research, and numerous recommendations has come out, but yet haven't been implemented, and there's continuous resistance to actually addressing the issues of travellers in this country. So today we are calling on the Taoiseach as the leader of the country to ensure this comes to an end and that there's real action taken on the issues facing travellers.
Today, Martin, we're standing outside the Leinster House along with the National Traveller Mental Health Network. And basically what the Mental Health Network has done was they've drafted a letter that they wanted to send into the Taoiseach. And in the letter, there's a demand for the trespass legislation to be repealed. There's a demand that the government holds themselves and holds everybody to account around traveller mental health, and basically what we're looking for is that the government sticks by their promise, and their promise was 20 months ago to implement an action plan for traveller mental health, and unfortunately they haven't done that yet. This time last year the Minister for Older People and for Mental Health met with us when we launched this pin, and you see the pin is the umbrella, it's to mark the traveller mental health network and the work and stuff that they've done. And look, Martin, we know what we want as the community to if you want better services, and all we're looking for is equality, but we can't do it ourselves, do you know what I mean? And we need the government need the government to support us in every way possible, and to stop making reports after reports, and stop like old stuff that's not working for us. And I think it's even today the Taoiseach couldn't accept the letter, someone even from the Taoiseach's office couldn't come out of that bit of respect and accept our letter that the network has done up, and that thousands of people has signed, over 4,000 people has signed. So that within itself is disrespectful to us as a community.
My name is Martin Collins and I'm the co-director of Pavy Point Travel and Roma Centre. I'm here today outside Dáil Éireann as part of a protest organised by the National Travel Health Network. So I'm here to offer a little bit of support and solidarity. I think it's a very important and worthy cause they're promoting. We're all too familiar with the levels of suicide and mental health issues in our community. And it's no exaggeration to say that it's an epidemic now. Hardly a week goes by we hear of young travellers taking their own lives, men and women. It's absolutely tragic, and we're here really to call the government into action. We don't think they're doing enough to support travel organisations to make the necessary interventions to try and support travellers who are suffering from mental health issues. So what we need really here is funding from the government so that travel organisations can have targeted interventions. But we also want to mainstream mental health institutions to be more responsive, to be more inclusive, and to be culturally appropriate in their response to the mental health crisis that quite clearly exists in our community. So I'm here, as I say, in support, in solidarity with the National Travel Health Network and all the other travel organisations to really call on the government to take the necessary action, and hopefully they will.
We need the state to act, as you've heard in all of the inputs this morning. We need action. We have the reports, we need action. Having said that, there is the need for the long-promised Traveller Mental Health Strategy to be developed in partnership with travellers and to be acted on when it's in place. And just well done to everyone here today and to the National Traveller Mental Health Network in terms of the organising it. And we all recognise that the numbers here today would have been much greater, but people were being encouraged to hold events locally in recognition. And I suppose I can't, on the day that's in it, I can't not say, you know, it's International Human Rights Day, and mental health and good mental health is a right and a human right, and it's important that it's seen in that framework of equality and human rights, and that the state acts on that and acts now.
So my name is John Collins. I'm a member of the National Travel Mental Health Network, and I'm just here today to we've actually come here today in protest on International Human Rights Day, just around the situation that Irish travellers find ourselves in when it comes to mental health. And look, over the past 20 years I've seen governments come and go, promise a lot, but we're looking for actual action this time instead of the promises and good reports, good recommendations, but that's as far as we get. And unfortunately, that's the situation we find ourselves in. So we're looking, hopefully the Taoiseach and the government will take it upon themselves, take a few steps further and try and sort out this crisis that we see with the travelling community and mental health.
Hi, I'm Rosemary Mon from the Irish Traveller Movement, and I'm here today as a traveller woman, standing with the National Traveller Mental Health Network, calling on the government to recognise our mental health crisis, to recognise the institutional racism that they have put upon us and all the organs of the state, and also members of our society that have sat back and watched that happen. Because we are having, for a very long time, for decades, a mental health crisis within our community.
So the plan is, this is the mental health wagon, and what we plan to do is, it was actually postponed because of the coronavirus restrictions, but we're going to visit every town across Ireland that has a high population of travellers, and we're going to fill the wagon with mental health material. So when the travellers come down, they'll go into the wagon, obviously they'll find the material in that private space, and we're just going to draw the travellers down to the wagon, hopefully, and just to highlight mental health, and we'll link in with that local youth or the local mental health service, if it's going to be in Galway, Cork, Belfast, wherever it's, and we'll link in with those, so when the actual mental health wagon moves on to the next town, that the travellers that live in that town will have the link with the mental health service if they ever did need access, just to basically spread the word and get the word out there among the community that there is support there for them if they're suffering with their mental health.
This is the letter, the open letter that has been signed by travellers far and wide and our allies. We've tried everything to get somebody to come out to accept the letter from us, but we haven't had any response. So we're going to hand the letter in right now.
We're calling on the state to do what you should have done decades ago. Apologise for the 1963 Commission on Itinerancy against us, which set out to assimilate us. Then we may be able to heal from the trauma that you have inflicted upon us as an Indigenous people. And then, all those recommendations that we have fought long and hard for, please invest in them. Please, we need real action. Please actually implement them and hold those accountable. The organs of your state that failed to implement them, hold them accountable, because we're here today saying enough is enough and traveller oppression has met its end.
Thank you.